Hello, and welcome to the Get to Know Hedge Fund Investing series. I'm Jamie Eppenberg. This is with Carl and the Carl Investment Platform. So today we're talking about the types of investors that we have seen going into hedge funds now that hedge funds are open to more accredited retail investors. We've talked about the lower minimums, the more data that's available to these investors, the liquidity. It's just a real 180 from the old world of hedge funds. So what does that mean? And, you know, who then can take advantage of these funds? I want to remind you that I am offering you the highest level in a very short period of time in talking about these funds. I hope to just give you enough information to get you started, to get you on the Carl mobile app so that you can look at these funds and give a reasonable review to what is the best selection for your portfolio, what's going to make the most utility sense in your portfolio. So from a high level, we see, and this will probably take two sessions to go through our investors. So today, I will talk about the traditional or stereotypical hedge fund investor. And I spoke about this a little bit in the last session. We think there's a stereotype in the world about hedge funds that the hedge fund investor will take on a great deal of risk in order to get this high return and in the midst could lose it all, right? I would say we're the first to tell you that there are a lot of bad hedge funds out there. They're often correlated to the market, which, I mean, why bother? And, you know, this stereotype exists for a reason. The way that Carl looks at this is you really need a partner, you need a professional, a hedge fund expert to be able to review hedge funds and help make a short list, right, of funds that at least from an institutional level or a strong investment perspective, we're removing some of that stereotype as much as we can out of the mix. So what that means is you're going to see the hedge funds on our platform. We may have these types of investors who are coming in. Maybe they have something they want. Maybe they want to buy a boat. Maybe they want to, you know, they're getting engaged or married or whatever it may be. And they're looking to double their money in 18 months. There are funds that you could look at that would have a historical profile that would accommodate that historically. They would have done that for the investor. I do have to mention historical performance is not always indicative of future performance. That's, you know, we all need to keep that in mind. While I do know most of you will be looking at historical statistics to make your investment decision, so we will mention them. So we have funds that do that. On the flip side, we still, in general, it would have to be really strong returns in order to validate a, you know, a crazy risk profile. Most of our risk profiles are still going to be better overall than the indexes. And so you'll want to look at those. So that when we talk about a risk profile, we're talking about annual volatility, the largest monthly loss, the worst drawdown, and the recovery periods. So those together are part of a risk profile of an investment. And as much as you look at the gains, you're going to want to look at those all together and see like how would that fit in your portfolio? How much risk are you taking on for the gain in a particular investment? So in the shiny ball category, we certainly have, which means I want to grow my money in a short period of time. What are my options? We do have those while we're still most of the time going to lower the investor's risk while they do that. And then, you know, that's not a large portion of our investors, that stereotype. I would say the largest portion of investors are those who want strong gains, but they're really looking for diversification. And historically, that's the institutions and the uber wealthy as well. It is actually difficult, quite difficult to find truly uncorrelated investments out there that can do whatever particular utility you're looking for in your portfolio. You can invest in different markets somewhat, but most of the time, the markets are moving together. The hedge funds really can provide that uncorrelated piece of the puzzle and give you a peace of mind that as the market moves, you have investments that will move on their own in potentially different directions. And when we go through the funds, you'll see that. And as you go through the graphs of the funds, as you look at the funds over different timeframes, you'll also see that they move quite differently than in the mobile app. You can compare them to the SPX, the S&P, and the Dow Jones. So you'll be able to see how they have reacted, how they do move differently than common markets. So diversification is key. Now, when I go, that is the biggest reason investors we see want to get into hedge funds. Can I make my portfolio more of a rainbow and have more opportunity to grow my money and have less losses so that I do have more money growing regardless of the type of market we're in at any given time? So that's probably the two types we're gonna talk about today. The shiny ball investors, which are not as large, and diversification, huge. When we go through the individual investments, I'll go more through the diversification and how we see the diversifiers looking at the funds. But we have two more types of investors to go through, and we'll do that in the next session. All right, we'll see you next time.